Let us discuss the effect of Earth's rotation on value of G at various points on its surface. If we consider this Earth, and we know well that about its axis of rotation, Earth is in continuous rotational motion. And say we are given the angular speed of rotation of Earth as omega e. And we know well that in a period of 24 hours, Earth revolves for a complete rotation. And if its time period is 24 hours or in number of seconds, it is 864,000 seconds. So the value of omega e is already known to us, which can be written as 2π/864,000 radians per second. When I require, we can use it. Now say if this is the equator of Earth, and at various points we wish to find out the value of gravity and the effect on the value of gravity due to rotation of Earth. Let us consider a point where a body is placed on Earth's surface, and say this is the point where we can state the body is located co-latitude lambda with respect to the axis of rotation. Then in this situation we can say if Earth radius is Re, so due to rotation of Earth, the body will also be revolving in a circle of radius Re sine lambda like this. Here we can see. And due to rotation with respect to Earth, body will experience a centrifugal force in outward direction, that is M omega E square Re sine lambda. And obviously, due to gravity, it will be experiencing an inward force or the weight of Earth, that is MGS. If GS is the gravity due to the gravitational field of Earth, or it is the gravitational field of Earth at the point where body is located. And if we measure the weight of body, effective weight would be relatively less, due to which it will exert a normal reaction on Earth surface, or Earth surface will react it with a normal reaction N. So here we can write, for equilibrium of this body, here we can write this N, and in this situation, if this angle is lambda, we can simply write that this angle will also be lambda geometrically. So along the direction of normal reaction, we can write there is a component of the centrifugal force, that is M omega E square Re sine square lambda, and that will be balanced by the weight of body at this point, which is MGS. Here we can write the contact force applied between Earth and body, or by body on Earth. This can be written as MGS minus M omega E square Re sine square lambda. And this contact force can be written as effective weight of body at this location, because this is a net force with which the body is pressing the Earth. So this can be written as W effective, and this can be written as M GS minus omega E square Re sine square lambda, where lambda is the angle of location of body with respect to Earth's axis of rotation, which is we can term it as co-latitude of the location of point on Earth's surface where body is located. And this effective weight can also be written as M multiplied by G effective. G effective is the effective gravity. So here we can see the value of effective gravity we are getting is GS minus omega E square Re sine square lambda. So this is quite a useful relation, and we can see as latitude or co-latitude at any point on Earth's surface changes, the value of effective gravity experienced by the body on Earth's surface changes. Here we can also see at poles, the value of lambda is zero. This implies we can write gravity at poles is equal to GS only, and the exact numerical value is 9.83 meter per second square. And if we talk about at equator, then at equator the value of lambda is π/2, and if we substitute it, then we can write gravity at equator is equals to GS minus omega E square Re when we substitute all values and calculate, this gives us a slightly lesser value, that is 9.78 meter per second square. So we can state that always gravity at equator is slightly less compared to gravity at poles. Always remember this analysis, as in many cases and applications, such analysis is used for calculation of effective gravity.